Children, our next lesson is maps, our guides. So here, maps are guiding us. So in which way they guide us? To know the information about the world or earth. Okay, it provide information about the earth surface and the globe. Already you know that. On the earth surface, so many variations are there. Okay, so already you know our earth is a blue planet. Why we called it is a blue planet? Why? Because when you observe the globe from other planets or from other from moon, so it is look like a blue ball. It is look like a blue ball. Why it look like a blue ball? Why? Because the most of the portion of the earth was filled with water. It is filled with water. That's why it is look like a ball. Clear? Okay. So how much percentage of earth is filled with water? Do you know that? How much percentage of earth filled with water?
71%.
71% of the earth filled with the water. So remaining 29% left landmass. Left for land. Clear? That's why. So 71% of the earth filled with water. So the deep water looks blue color, appears blue color. So that's why it's look like a ball. Clear? Very good. So to understand the surface of the globe, variations on the earth somewhere, variations means the land mass on the earth is not equal. Not plain. Okay, not plain. You can observe so many mountains, so many hills, low places. Okay, when you travel from Hyderabad to your native place, I think you observed that, you experienced that. So many hills you can observe the roadside. So like that, the surface of the earth is not equal everywhere. Somewhere deserts are there in our country, okay, and mountains, Himalayas are there, plateaus are there, plains are there, rivers are there, so many rivers, Ganga, Yamuna, Godavari, Krishna, river valleys are there, deltas are there, like that, so many changes are there on the earth surface. Clear? So many changes, not same, all the places are not same. So, to know the information about these places, so we use maps or globe. Maps or globe. First one, what is the meaning of map? You know some maps, names of the map. Which maps you know? Which maps you know?
India maps.
India map, world map. Okay, like that you know these maps. But what is the meaning of map? So usually map is a representation of the earth's surface. What we know? We know information about the earth surface. So which land, which type of lands are there in our country or in the world? Which type of forests are growing in the world? Okay, and what are the rivers are there? What are the mountains are there? Okay, where the plateaus are there? Where the deserts are there? Clear? Like that, we know the information about the earth surface with the help of maps. Clear? So a map is a representation of the earth surface. first of all. So once upon a time, they used maps for to know the information of at surface and some other information of the earth. But nowadays we are using maps for every purpose. We are using maps not only the physical features of the earth. We are using maps for every purpose. Example, can I take example now? In the world is afraiding about COVID virus. Okay, so Farhan, switch off your audio. Farhan, switch off your audio. Okay, so we are suffering with COVID. So how to we can explain COVID about COVID with the help of map? How can we explain with the help of map? So example, in our India, how many states are there?
29 states.
Now in which state COVID cases are more? In which case, which state
COVID? Maharashtra.
In which state COVID cases are less? Okay, like that. This information we can we explain with the help of map. You can take the India map, political map. Then you can write in the Maharashtra COVID cases this much. In Rajasthan, COVID cases this much. In Telangana, COVID cases this much. In Meghalaya, COVID cases this much. Can we explain with the help of map? We can explain. Take the India map, political map, all the states. So write down the total number of cases in the each state. So after observing this map, we can conclude that in which state more cases are there, in which state less cases are there. Can we identify? Yeah, so that is the use of map. Like that, nowadays we can explain any information, any topic with the help of map. Clear? That is the importance of map. So even about education, about population, about forest, about soils, okay, about literacy, about poverty, about industries, about schools. So every information we can explain with the help of map. So these are the uses of maps. First point. Okay, clear? Next, maps help to construct dams. Maps help to lay roads. If you want to lay road between two villages. So which information we should know? So first of all, which lands are available? Either government's lands are available to lay the road or not. Okay. And another one is the height of the places. The height of the places we should know to lay the road. Okay. Which soils are there in that area to construct a road? So all these information we can find with the help of maps. Okay, so we use different maps for different purpose. We should not show every information in one single map. Can you show all the information in one single map? About forest, about lands, about deserts, about mountains, all those. About literacy, about population. We cannot show every information in single map. So we use different maps for different information. Clear? For every information, we use one separate map. So now come to the lesson. So here, can you guess which came first, the globe or the map? The globe or the map? Which came first? And which is we prepared?
Map.
Map. Why? How can you say map?
Here there is oldest map, so which
means okay. So we don't know either the earth is round or flat, okay, up to before 300-400 years back, but our ancient people prepared map 4000 years ago our ancient people prepared the map. Okay, that is where they prepared with the help of clay tablet. Clay means mud. They prepared with the clay. So while they used the clay at the time, they don't know about paper, pen, pencil. Okay, that's why they wrote all the information on the stones or on the bark of the trees, okay, on leaves at the time. Okay, Mahabharata, Ramayan, all those wrote in leaves or bark of the trees. They don't know at the time, they don't have any paper. So that's why these people, our ancient people, prepared maps on clay tablet. Tablet means they prepared a round shaped or a triangle shaped clay. Okay, then they were drawn map on the tablet. Clear? So when before 400 years ago, but globe was prepared only 100 years back. Means, so which come first? Maps came first in use. The first point. Okay, maps are came first in the, yeah. They depicted the earth on flat surface called map. Once upon a time, our ancient people thought that earth is like a flat. Earth is flat surface. Flat. And they assumed that if they reach the edge of the earth, they may fall into sky. They don't know. So they thought, they don't know that this much information. That's why they thought that if you reach, it is a flat surface, if you reach edge of the land, they feared that they fall into the sky. That's why people never traveled edge of the earth. Okay. They assumed that the earth is flat. Okay. Next. That's why. So maps came first. Later only we prepared the globe. So after so many years, people understood it is not flat, it is a round ball. It is look like a round ball. Then only they prepared the globe. Okay. Next. So shall we see the map and continents on the map? Clear? Just wait. I will share the screen. Wait, Nana, it is downloading. So let us see the from the globe, continents and other oceans on the map.
Sir, came, sir.
So already you know the picture of the globe. Previous also we have observed, this is the globe. Okay, Emma, is it visible? Mitran?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is globe. You can see this is also called globe. These are available in the market. Even you can see in our school. Okay, it is called model of the earth. Model of the earth. So on the globe we drawn continents, oceans and everything. Okay, so if you take this, if you take this, so here blue colored, so the place which is colored with blue means what is the meaning of this? These places are filled with water. These are all oceans. So the blue color shade is water. Okay, next, other colored places are continents. How many continents we have? Ma, how many continents are there?
29 states. Continent.
I am asking.
Continent.
Continents. Seven continents are there. Continent means a big land mass on the earth, which is called continent. A big land mass.
Mean territory.
No.
Territory, sir.
Not territories. Oh, okay, territories or big land mass on the earth. So you can see here, this is a big piece of land, okay, in the middle of the ocean. Okay, here you can see this. This is also a big piece of land. So a giant piece of land is called a continent. A giant piece of land is called a continent. How many giant pieces are there, land pieces on the earth? Seven. So those are called seven continents. Seven continents. What are those seven continents? First one is Asia. Asia, Africa, Europe, North America, South America, Australia, Antarctica. Can I tell again? How many continents are there? Someone on the audio, that's why getting disturbed. Please switch off your audios. Rahan, switch off your audio. What is it? Farhan, switch off your audio.
On, sir.
Switch off, not on. Off. Audio, not video. Both. Better you stop both. Okay? Just wait, I'm sharing again. Okay. Then you can observe how many continents are there? Seven. How many? Seven continents are there. Which is called continent? A giant land mass on the earth. okay, big piece, big land piece on the earth, that is called a continent. How many are there? 7 are there. What are those? Already I said Asia. Tell, you also tell along with me. Asia,
Asia,
Asia, Europe,
Europe,
Africa,
Africa,
South America,
South America,
North America,
North America,
Australia,
Australia,
Antarctica,
Antarctica.
Yes, these 7 are called continents.
Continent.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Very good. So we can see all these information in our atlas. Atlas means a book, collection of maps. Atlas means, did you see the atlas? No, did you see the atlas? No, we didn't see. Okay, okay. It is a book of maps. In that atlas, we can see different maps. Different maps, world maps, India map, district maps, with every information. It explains about all the countries, all the continents, oceans, okay, land masses, hills, everything. It is called a atlas. It is a collection of maps. It is a collection of maps. So we can see all this information in atlas. A book of maps is called an atlas. So likewise, we are having different types of maps. Already said, we cannot show every information on one map. We use different maps to show different information on map. That is important. Okay, we use different maps. So like that, types of maps also there. We have different kinds or different types of maps, like country maps, state maps, district maps, world map, continent map. Okay, like that. Okay, now see the differences between globe and map. Already we have discussed about globe in the previous class. Am I correct? We have discussed about globe in the previous class. We are discussing about map in this present class. But we have to understand, we should understand the differences between globe and map. Okay, so in your textbook also given those. So how the globe is useful? We can see only one side of our world at a time, at a single glance. So
all the places are covered on a single globe. So they are small and not clear.
So here you can see here, Amas, look into the screen. So if you take this globe, Ma, is it visible? This is a globe.
Yes.
So we can see here only Africa and Europe and Asia. Which continents are there this side?
Sure.
Asia. This is the globe, one side. Okay, here globe is there. It is showing only one side. What are there on the globe? Which continents are there? Africa, Europe, and Asia. Is it showing North America, South America, Australia? No.
No, sir.
Or no. Which side they are? Another side.
Another side.
Of the globe. Okay. Okay, only another side of the globe they are located, but we are able to see only these three continents on the one side of the globe. But where are remaining continents? Are they disappear? No, they are there. In which side? Another side of the globe. So this is the defect of the globe. So if you observe the globe, we can see only one side of our world at a time, at a single glance. Single glance. We cannot see another side. If you want to see another side, what you have to do? We have to rotate the globe. Okay, we have to rotate the globe. Then we can see the another side. But we cannot see the what we observed in the previous. Clear? Very good. But in on the map, we can see all the continents and everything at a time, at a glance. Example, here you can take the map. This is the map. So we can see all at a time. North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Asia, Australia, Antarctica. Okay? So what is the difference between globe and map? First difference is we cannot see total world at a time on the globe. But we can see total world at a time on the map. Clear? On the map, we can see at a time. Already you are seeing here. Okay, here it is a map. Everything is there here. All continents are visible on the map, but on the globe we cannot see. Only one side we can see. If you want to see another side, that should be rotated. At the time also we can see another side, but not what we cannot see what we saw in the previous. That is the main difference between. Farhan, say the difference between globe and map. Now only we discuss now.
Globe is a.
On the globe, we can see whole world. We cannot see whole world, globe, or world. It is single time, single glance. Okay, say. Farhan.
Yes, sir.
We cannot see whole world at a time or at a single glance on a globe.
No.
But on a map, we can see whole world at a time and in a single glance. Mitran. What is the main difference between globe and map?
We can see only one side of our world at a time, at a single glance.
No.
We can see the whole world at a time, at a glance.
Yes, that is the main difference between globe and a map. And second difference is all the places are covered
on a single globe. So they are small and not clear.
On a single globe. So they are small and not clear. If you show everything on the globe, we cannot prepare globe in a big size. If you prepare a big size, we cannot hold. Okay? We can prepare globe in a small size. That's why. So all the places which is showing on the globe, they are very small, not clear. But on the map, each place can be shown on a different map. And you can prepare different continent maps. We can take only Asian continent in one map, okay? African continent in one map, Europe continent in another map, like that. So if you prepare a single map for different continents. So we can show all in a big size and clear. Okay, so each place can be shown on a different map, so the places are big and clear. So second difference is, so on globe we cannot show big and clear on the globe, but in map we can show the places big and clear. This is second difference. So third difference is, it shows the true shape of the earth, globe. So already we have discussed in the previous class, globe is a model of the earth, same as it is. We cannot see earth, okay? We cannot see total earth at a time. Why? Because it is very large planet. If you want to see earth with your eyes, you should go to moon. From moon you can see our earth. From another planet we can see our earth. Okay, we cannot see total earth by standing on the earth. That is impossible. That's why, how to understand about our earth with the help of globe. With the help of globe. That's why it shows the true shape of the earth, and it is also called the model of the earth. Clear? So, but map, it cannot show the true shape of the earth, but gives us detailed information. It cannot show the shape of the earth. Why? The map is a flat. How we prepare? Ma. Map is a flat paper, but earth is not flat. Already you know, earth is not flat. Earth, it is round in shape. Earth is a round in shape, but globe shows the true shape of the earth, but map doesn't show the true shape of the earth. These are three main differences between globe and map. Clear? Okay, here three differences given between globe and map. Once again we can see, so first difference is, we can see only one side of our world at a time at a single glance with the help of globe. We can see the whole world at a time, at a glance, with the help of map. Second point, all the places are covered on a single globe, so they are small and not clear. We can prepare globe in a single, small size, not a large size. That's why the places are shown in a small size on the globe. But on the map, we can prepare maps for different places, different continents separately. That's why we can show places in a large size. Third point, it shows the true shape of the earth. Globe shows the true shape of the earth. It is also called, globe is a model of the earth. But on map, we cannot show the true shape of the earth. Why? Because it prepared flat. Map is flat paper, that's why, but it gives us detailed information. So these are the differences between map and globe. Clear? Any doubts? No? Okay. So let us end the session. So after this, write the important points and send to me. Okay. So I will send the recorded class also. Clear now? Okay, bye.
Bye, sir. Bye, sir.